Good morning, 11th students. Lesson number 6, Thermodynamics. In part 5, I will teach you the topic. This one, 6.4, enthalpy change, delta H of a reaction, reaction enthalpy. Okay? 6.4, enthalpy change, delta H of a reaction, reaction enthalpy. Page 170. Okay, now earlier you are knowing that reactants are going to convert into products. This is called the chemical reactions. Reactants are converting into products. When we are, okay, the enthalpy change accompanying a reaction is called a reaction enthalpy. Okay, the enthalpy change means delta H. The enthalpy change of a chemical reaction is given by the symbol delta reaction RH. So delta RH is equal to sum of enthalpies of products minus sum of enthalpies of reactants. This is represented by sum, means this one is sigma at a given temperature. This one is all products, A, enthalpies of products, okay, A1. B, I, reactants. This equation is called the 6.41. I will show you again. See, reactants are going to convert into products. Now we have to show the enthalpy change. So delta H for what? Delta for reaction is sum of enthalpies of products. See, products minus reactants. How will you represent sigma at a given temperature? Okay, we will write A, products symbol, total AT, and H for products. In this way, you close the bracket, minus sigma at a given temperature, B, I, and H reactants, enthalpy for reactants. This equation is called 6.14, and this is called sigma. Sigma means total, is used for summation. It is called summation, means total. We have to do total. And AT and BT are stoichiometric coefficients of the products and reactants. Stoichiometric coefficients for this one is for products and this one is for reactants. Okay, for example, I am taking one reaction. This I will show you by one reaction. I am taking reaction methane gas plus 2O2 gas. You have to show the state also, and it is going to convert a CO2 gas plus 2H2O liquid. Methane, when heated with oxygen, going to convert into carbon dioxide and liquid water. Here we have to show the change of enthalpies is equal to summation. First of all, you note this one is products and reaction. So water products, first of all, these are reactants. Okay, so products are two. We have to write summation. Instead of summation, we have to write both these two, because we are doing total here. So this one is HmCO2 gas plus 2. So we have to write 2 H2O liquid state. Inside you have to write liquid and then close the bracket. Minus, for the reactants you have to write HM. What is HM? I will tell you. CH4 you have to write in gas notation, plus another one is 2O2. 2 you have to write HM. Here also you have to write HM, then close the bracket, then O2 in gaseous state and close the bracket. Okay, now where HM is molar enthalpy for 1 mole. Okay, So here we were writing H products, no? So we will write here HM for CO2, 2 H2O, so 2 molar enthalpy HM for H2O minus HMCS4 gas plus 2O2. Okay, this one is called molar enthalpy. Now enthalpy change. Enthalpy change is a very useful quantity. This is very useful quantity. First point, knowledge of this quantity. Knowledge of this quantity is required when one needs to plan the heating or cooling. If we are heating the water, okay, heating, so liquid is going to convert into vapor or cooling. Means by reverse, it will convert into ice. Otherwise, we are doing heating, otherwise we are doing cooling. Required to maintain an industrial chemical reaction at constant temperature. It is also required to calculate temperature dependence of equilibrium constant. Okay, so this is the importance of enthalpy change. Now, we are starting our first topic in that standard enthalpy. Standard enthalpy of reactions. Okay, so what is that? Enthalpy of reaction depends on the conditions under which a reaction is carried out. So it is necessary to specify some standard conditions. The standard enthalpy of reaction is the enthalpy change for reactions when all the participating substances are in their standard states. Okay. Now, what is standard state? The standard enthalpy of reaction is the enthalpy change of a reaction when all the participating substances are in their standard states. Now, the standard state of a substance at a specified temperature as it is in pure form at 1 bar. Okay. For example, liquid ethanol at 298 Kelvin is pure liquid ethanol at 1 bar. Okay, so it is standard. Standard state of pure solid iron at 500 Kelvin is pure iron at 1 bar. Usually, data are taken at 298 Kelvin. Standard condition are denoted by adding the superscript this to the symbol. So delta H example at a standard will be represented by this change. Okay. Now our next topic is B, enthalpy change during transformation. Now what is called transformation? Now phase transformation also involve energy changes. Ice, for example, requires heat for melting. If we are keeping ice on open space in open table, it requires heat, means sunlight or whatever outer areas, and it will melt. Normally this melting takes place at constant pressure, atmospheric pressure. We are feeling 1 bar, and during phase change, temperature remains constant at 273 Kelvin. We are not giving any heat. So H2O solid, ice is going to convert into liquid. That heat is called the heat of fusion, and that is at a standard is this 6 kilojoule per mole. Here this fusion H ice going to convert into liquid. Okay. So H2O solid is going to convert into H2O liquid. This is called heat of fusion. Okay. If water freezes, and this is called standard heat of fusion at a standard state. So enthalpy of fusion in a standard state. Enthalpy of fusion at a standard state. If vice versa, if water freezes, then process is reversed. See, liquid turns into ice, means water freezes, then process is reversed and equal amount of heat is given off to the surrounding. Okay, we are keeping water in fridge, and so we are giving amount of heat given off to the surrounding. Now this is called the enthalpy change that accompanies melting of one mole of a solid substance in standard state is called standard enthalpy of fusion or molar enthalpy of fusion. This one is called molar enthalpy from ice to liquid. Melting of a solid is endothermic. Heat is not going to liberate, but we are supplying. So all enthalpies of fusion are positive. You can see in the table this temperature enthalpy of fusion. I'm taking about enthalpy of fusion. Now water requires heat for evaporation. Okay, from liquid state to vapor state, liquid to vapor. So for at constant temperature of its boiling point TB, we are boiling the temperature, that is called the temperature for boiling liquid to convert it into vapor. At constant pressure means H2O liquid to H2O vaporization, or it is called the gaseous, from liquid to gaseous. And that heat is heat of vaporization for water. Vaporization is equal to 40.79 kilojoule per mole. We are giving, so it is positive. So amount of heat required to vaporize one mole of a liquid at constant temperature and under standard pressure, one bar, is called the standard enthalpy of vaporization or molar enthalpy of vaporization. Now amount of heat required to vaporize one mole of liquid, any liquid, I am taking H2O, one mole of liquid, this is one mole of liquid at constant temperature. Temperature should be constant. At constant temperature and under standard pressure means at constant STP condition, this is called STP condition, standard temperature and pressure, 273 Kelvin standard and 1 bar pressure. One mole of liquid is going to convert into, is called standard enthalpy of vaporization. This is called standard enthalpy of vaporization or molar enthalpy. This is called molar enthalpy of vaporization. This is standard enthalpy, molar enthalpy for vaporization. Okay, now first I taught you, second, now third, sublimation. First I told you heat of fusion, then heat of vaporization, second, now third one is sublimation. Now what is sublimation? You are knowing, no, when you are burning solid agarbatti or camphor, they are going to convert. Otherwise what is going on? Solid first of all converting into liquid, then into gas. But in sublimation, solid is going to convert in direct into gas. Camphor, it is a good example. Or otherwise you are keeping bathroom fresheners, they are in solid state, they are going to convert into sublimated into gas. Camphor, agarbatti, naphthalene balls, etc. They are the good examples for sublimation. Okay, sublimation is directly conversion of a solid into vapor. Solid into vapor. Okay, now solid CO2, you are knowing, no, dry ice, solid CO2 which is kept for the to fire, for fire extinguisher in kept, or dry ice sublimize at 195 Kelvin. Okay, with heat of sublimation is equal to 25.2 kilojoule per mole. Naphthalene sublimation, naphthalene which I told you, you are keeping in the bathrooms for freshness. Naphthalene sublimates slowly, and for this kilojoule per mole. Okay, so standard enthalpy of sublimation, standard heat, this is standard heat of sublimation, is the change in enthalpy when 1 mole of a solid substance sublimizes at a constant temperature and under standard pressure. Okay, now today I taught you 3 standard fusion, vaporization and sublimation. The magnitude of the enthalpy change, the magnitude of the enthalpy change depends on the strength of the strength of intermolecular interaction in substances, interaction in substances undergoing the phase transformation. Phase transformation means from solid to liquid, from liquid to gas, or from solid to gas. This is called phase transformation. For example, the strong hydrogen bonds, strong hydrogen bond between water molecules hold them tightly in liquid phase. For an organic liquid such as an acetone, when you will come for the organic chemistry, you will know what is acetone. It is the ketone group, CO ketone group, acetone, and it is used for the nail polish remover also. It is having a cooling effect. For an organic liquid such as acetone, the intermolecular dipole-dipole interactions are significantly weak. Dipole-dipole movement earlier I taught you. For an organic liquid such as an acetone, the intermolecular dipole-dipole interactions, dipole-dipole interactions are significantly weaker. Thus, it requires less heat to vaporize. Okay? If it's strong, then it requires more heat. But if they are having weaker bond, then easily they can be vaporized. Thus, it requires less heat to vaporize 1 mole of acetone than it does to vaporize 1 mole of water. So, what is the reason? In water, there are strong hydrogen bond, and in acetone, there are weaker. So, it will easily vaporize. It will take time. So, heat of vaporization, here it is more, okay, and it will easily boil, vaporize. So table 6.1 gives value of standard enthalpy changes of fusion and vaporization for some substances, heat of fusion and heat of vaporization. Okay students, I think as I am teaching you, you are making your notes. Please be regular with me.